Broadway presents the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Brought to you by Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield's mildness, plus no unpleasant aftertaste. By Anacin for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. By Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor. And by Beam and Pepsin, the gum that's great to chew and good for your digestion, too. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our master of ceremony.
Hi, folks, this is Dean Martin. Well, another Friday has arrived, which means that the orchestra is raring to go and the script is on hand. In fact, all the familiar elements are here but one, my undernourished partner, Jerry Lewis. Well, he just dropped down to the blood bank to give a pint, and they're busy giving him 2 pints change. So, while Jerry gets stocked up on the red and white corpuscles, I'd like to give you a sample of the Sailor's Polka. So, Richard, downbeat.
Come on and play the Sailor's Polka. Make way for Navy Blues. How the girls all love the polka with a sailor who's tried and true. Where there is music and there's moonlight, the Navy knows what to do. So come on and play the sailor's polka. Make way for Navy Blue. Come on and play the sailor's polka. Make way for Navy Blue. Oh, how the girls all love the polka with a sailor who's tried and true. Where there is music and there's moonlight, the Navy knows what to do. So come on and play the sailor's polka. Make way for Navy Blue.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure.
Don't let them do the soldiers. Polka.
Now, what are you doing? Who sent for you?
What do you mean, who sent for me? I was 10 feet away. This requires an escort.
Oh, you know what I mean. Who sent for you? Who needs all this noise?
Listen here, Dean Martin. It's about time you realize that the name of this act is Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis, not Dean Martin and Silence.
Now, look, Jerry, in the first place, this is a radio show, and in the second place, your kind of screaming just doesn't belong.
Yeah, well, if we didn't have my screaming in the second place, we wouldn't have a show in the first place.
Well, I give up. These conversations are positively inane. You understand? They're inane. I-N-A-N-E.
They gave you blocks for Christmas. You're learning to spell.
Jerry, you're just going to have to change your ways.
Listen, buddy, I don't have to change. Everyone likes me just the way I am.
Who's everybody?
The public and me.
The public and I.
Oh, you too?
No, not me too. See, you don't even know when you've been insulted.
Yeah, you just don't appreciate me. All you see is a homely, scrawny kid, but I have inner beauty.
You have inner beauty. Who said so?
My doctor.
Oh.
Well, find out for yourself. Go ahead. Look down my throat. Aren't I exquisite?
All right, Jerry. There's no more time for argument. It's time for our first guest.
Goodness, we're expecting a guest, and my hair is a positive mess.
So is that line. I invited one of the country's leading insurance salesmen to talk to us tonight, and...
Excuse me for interrupting, Dean, but we just received a call that your insurance salesman guest is in an automobile accident. He won't be able to make it.
Hey, Dean, I got an idea. How about letting me act like the insurance salesman?
All righty. Folks, I'd like you to meet the man who has piled up one of the greatest sales records in the insurance field. The top insurance salesman of 1951, Mr. Orrin J. Wick. Mr. Wick, it's a pleasure to shake your hand.
Take it harder, buddy. Go ahead and scream.
You're pretty strong, Mr. Wick.
No, I'm kind of weak, but those fingers are insured for $10,000.
You mean each one of your fingers is insured for $1,000? That's the silliest insurance policy I ever heard of.
Greatest little investment in the world. Wright needs a new coat. All I have to do is break one little finger, and there's cash on the barrelhead.
Well, tell me, why do you consider insurance such a wonderful thing?
Well, take the case of Mr. X.
Oh, you can't mention his name?
I just did. His name is X. You know him. He's the guy who invented iodine.
Oh, I see. Well, what about him?
X came from a very poor family. Mother, father, six kids, and a sheepdog named Henry. The father never made more than $40 a week. But by golly, the man was insured. Ain't that wonderful?
Well, what's so wonderful?
Well, there's a man who toiled and labored, and every month for 52 years, that man paid his insurance premium. Then one day, he died. And do you know that that insurance company did for his wife? Do you know what they did?
Well, I can't imagine.
They saw to it that she didn't have to pay another premium for the rest of her life.
I wonder if you could help me with some of my insurance problems.
You might like our breaded 20-payment meal cutlet plan.
Breaded 20-payment meal cutlet? What's that?
Well, with this policy, if you get splattered with hot grease while frying meal cutlet, you're completely covered.
Well, seriously, Mr. Wick, when an insured person passes away, does your company pay off fast?
Pay off fast, boy. Pay off fast. Why, we had one client that had his office on the 51st floor of our building, and one day he fell out the window.
Did you pay off fast?
Fast. We handed him a check as he passed our floor.
Did he collect double indemnity?
No, that's only for accidental death.
Falling out of a 50th floor window sure sounds like accidental death to me.
You better read your fine print, son. When you fall 50 flights, it's an accident if you live. I know you can.
Now come back, Jay. It's time for all of us to sound off with a good New Year's Eve tip.
Ring out the old and ring in the new. We've got some good advice for you. Smoke Chesterfields the evening through.
No aftertaste at 52.
Mildness plus.
No aftertaste.
Mildness plus.
No aftertaste.
No unpleasant aftertaste in Chesterfield.
That's right.
Your holiday parties can't go wrong if you will heed this little song.
Have Chesterfield for every guest. They know the one that's really best.
Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
Milder, 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 Chesterfield.
That's right!
Folks, it's a fact. Keeping a few extra cartons of Chesterfield within easy reach means that along with the rest of the evening's fun, you'll be giving your guests smoking pleasure all the way. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. Over 1,500 tobacco growers tell you Chesterfields are milder. One of the world's most famous industrial research organizations reports that of all brands tested, only Chesterfield leaves no unpleasant aftertaste. Stock up on those extra cartons tomorrow. Well, a few weeks ago, I sang an up-and-coming number and received a lot of nice letters from a lot of nice people telling me how much they liked the song. Well, the song is still climbing pretty fast, and if you don't mind, I'd like to try it again. So, Ricardo, our newest latest recording, Blue Smoke.
Blue smoke goes drifting by into the deep blue sky. And when I think of home, I sadly sigh. Oh, I can see you there with love and tears in your eyes. As we fondly said our last goodbye, and as I sailed away with a longing to stay, I promised I'd be true and love only you. Blue smoke goes drifting by into the deep blue sky. My memories of home will never die.
Now, as the blue smoke disappears, we call your attention to the appearance of Jimmy Wallington.
Thank you, Dean. Ladies and gentlemen, no matter what you now take for headache relief, we urge you to try Aniston for the incredibly fast relief these tablets bring the next time you're suffering from a headache. Now, the reason Aniston is so wonderfully fast-acting and effective is this. Aniston is like a doctor's prescription. That is, Aniston contains not just one, but a combination of medically proven active ingredients in easy-to-take tablet form. Thousands of people have received envelopes containing Aniston tablets from their own dentist or physician, and in this way discovered the incredibly fast relief Aniston brings from pains of headache, neuritis, or neuralgia. So the next time a headache strikes, take Aniston for this wonderfully fast relief. Aniston. A-N-A-C-I-N. Aniston. At any drug counter in handy boxes of 12 and 30. Economical family-sized bottles of 50 and 100.
You know, westerns have always been among the most popular movies, and some people go to watch the handsome hero and others enjoy the riding and shooting. But if you're anything like Jerry and myself, when you go see a western, it's always in hopes of seeing our lovely guest star. She's the wife and co-star of our number one cowboy, Roy Rogers, and a wonderful gal, Miss Dale Evans.
Thank you, Dean. Well, where is it?
Where's what?
Well, I heard you work with a Shetland pony that walks on its hind legs and howls like a coyote.
Oh, you mean Jerry. Well, he'll be along soon enough, Dale. But first, I thought you might like to get us in a kind of western groove with one of those songs you do so well.
Well, I'd be happy to, Dean. If you can enlist the boys in the band, I'll just whip right into it.
Well, good enough, Dale. Now, folks, with the aid of Dick Stabile and his bouncing buckaroos, here's Dale Evans singing Tea is for Texas.
Just a prairie canary with a heart that's warm as toast. But somehow I don't want to marry. Guess I love the range the most. Tea for Texas, that's the place for me. Plains are rolling, far as the eye can see. If you want to know all about my life, I'm descended from David Crockett. And I cut my teeth on a Bowie knife with a 45 in my pocket. Tea for Texas, that's the place for me. Plains are rolling, far as the eye can see. Now you look here, friend, I'm a Texas hen, and when we make a date to dance and sup, you better not show up a dollar short and an hour late. Tea for Texas, that's the place for me. Plains are rolling, far as the eye can see. One day I went out to California to get myself a break, but they told me out there my talk was corny and that I just couldn't take. Tea for Texas.
that was lovely, Dale. Real lovely. You know something, Dale?
Yes, Dean. You know what?
Hey, who's the cowhand?
Jerry, this happens to be Mrs. Rogers.
Rogers? Yeah, I used to see you in those dancing pictures with Fred Astaire.
Look, Jerry, I'm not
that... Tell the truth. Did Astaire do all the dancing, or was it really William Bendix?
Jerry, I didn't mean Ginger Rogers.
Look, I think I'd better explain to him, Dean. You see, Jerry, I'm Mrs. Roy Rogers, otherwise known as Dale Evans.
Oh, how'd you do?
How'd you do?
I'm Jerry Lewis, otherwise known as Jerry the Adorable.
Jerry, Dale happens to be married to Roy Rogers, the rugged cowboy star. And I don't think he'd like your attitude.
Dale, do you think he heard what I said?
Oh, don't worry, Jerry. Roy wouldn't harm a hair on your head.
Never mind the hair on my head. How about the head under my hair?
Tell the truth, Dale. Have you ever seen anything like Jerry before?
Oh, sure. We sent one to the stockyard, but they refused it.
Boy, now that does it. Now I'm mad. Western style, too. My trigger finger is really itching.
Itching? To shoot somebody?
No, I have a mosquito bite.
Oh, you don't seem to know anything about the West, Jerry.
Sure I do, Dale. Why, when I was a kid, I went to all those Western movies to see the bad men and the Indians and the shooting and roping and riding, and then I'd go home to bed, and do you know what I dream about?
No. What?
Girls.
Jerry, you didn't learn a thing watching those Westerns?
I didn't, eh? Well, get a load of this.
Howdy, ma'am. Yep, and right front of.
Western talk is easy for me. I got bow-legged teeth.
You know something, Jerry? I bet you'd enjoy some of our real Western ranch life.
And I bet our listeners would like to know how a couple of big Western stars live on that ranch of yours, Dale.
Well, I guess Roy wouldn't mind if I tell a few family secrets. So if you fellas will lend me a hand, let's head for the ranch, huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, for Western movie fans everywhere, we proudly present Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and Dale Evans in Life with Trigger. We take you now to the San Fernando Valley, where men are men and women are women, and you can't tell them apart because they all wear Levi's. Our scene is a rustic little 42-room cabin, picturesquely settled beneath a towering, snow-capped mortgage. Our characters?
My name's Roy Rogers. I live on this ranch with my wife, Dale, and my horse, Trigger.
My name is Dale Evans. I live on this ranch with my husband, Roy, and his horse, Trigger.
My name is Trigger. Oh, here comes my master, Roy Rogers.
Hi, Trigger, old boy. Time for dinner. Follow me into the house, boy. Just wait till you taste that hay tonight.
Boy, did they take advantage. With all the money I make, look what they feed me.
Is that you, Roy?
Yeah, I brought Trigger in for dinner.
Trigger? But he eats like a horse.
$1,000 a week. I should eat like a turtle.
Roy, tell Trigger to wipe those hooves on the mat and hang that saddle in the hall closet.
Now, you do that, Fig. I'm going to see what's cooking.
I can't help it. Down deep, I love them both. Especially her. Even if she is a girl. Gosh, when she rubs my nose and feeds me sugar. $1,000 a week in lumps, I get. Ah, but what's the use? I love her anyhow. I'll tell her. For the first time they'll hear me talk, I'll just sidle up to her real quiet like. I won't make a sound. Darn those shoes. I told that blacksmith 5 times I wear a 9.5 AAA.
Hi, Trigger. You can start on your hay. You carve the turkey, Roy, and I'll get the banana shortcake.
I'll bet I'm the only horse leading a dog's life.
What was that?
That was Trigger. He spoke.
So I spoke. I'm not entitled.
But you're a horse.
No, you're a horse.
Oh, this is crazy. Horses can't talk.
Okay, so I can't talk. The turkey in the plate is a ventriloquist.
Well, Trigger, why didn't you tell us you could talk?
Well, it's bad enough I have to chase rustlers and run across prairies and jump over cliffs. But I'll be darned if I'm going to be the one that says he went that away.
Well, you shouldn't have held back this information, Trigger. That was downright selfish of you.
Selfish? Listen, sister, I carry the act as it is.
Yeah? Well, since you carry the act, let's practice your tricks. Go ahead and dance for us.
No, please don't make me dance. You know I dance like a horse.
I said dance. Up on your hind legs and dance.
Okay, but this time I'll leave.
All right.
Roy, I wish you'd stop making Trigger do things against his will.
Gosh, those are the first kind words you said about me.
Well, I've been kind of jealous. But underneath, I really love you, Trigger.
You do? Then kiss me.
But I've never kissed a horse before.
Ah, come on. It's no different than kissing a cow.
Really, Roy, isn't this touching?
What touching? My wife and my best friend, this is touching.
Well, things are going to be different now.
Yes, sirree. From now on, it's going to be peace and harmony. Just the three of us.
We live on a ranch, and we love the life.
I'm Dave.
I'm Roy.
I'm Trigger.
I live with my horse and my little wife.
I'm small.
I'm big.
I'm bigger.
We ride on the plains as we herd our beef.
We ride to bring punishment to each thief.
I wish when they ride, they would ride the chief.
I'm Dale.
I'm Roy.
For us to temporarily retire and hand the mic over to Jimmy Wallington.
Thank you, Dean. And now here's something of interest to everybody.
Chiclets. Chiclets.
Taste the difference when you chew. Flavor on the outside, inside, too.
Chiclets. Chiclets.
Time the difference by the clock. Flavor lingers. Tick, tick, tock.
Chiclets. Chiclets.
Count the difference. Count 'em, cousin. Every box, an even dozen.
Chiclets. Chiclets. Chiclets.
Get the big nickel's worth. You can taste the difference, time the difference, count the difference. And whether you chew gum to keep your mouth fresh and clean, or just for the plain fun of chewing it, you'll be better off on every count with Chiclets. They're flavored on the outside, flavored on the inside. With Chiclets, you don't chew the flavor out, you chew the flavor in. That's why the goodness lingers on and on.
They're candy-coated.
Flavor-coated.
Pleasure-coated.
And more fun for your money. So get the big nickel's worth.
Chiclets. Chiclets. Chiclets.
Well, I guess some of our most pleasant thoughts come in that time just between fancy and reality, when we're wide awake and our minds pile dream upon dream, and young or old, when a guy meets that certain girl, that's when this conscious framework of dreams built to the sky. First time it happened to me, a certain piece of music was attaining great popularity. I'm sure most of you remember, with my wide open, I'm dreaming. Can it be true? I'm holding you close to my heart.
afraid to close my eyes, afraid that I'll find this lovely thrill is just a silly illusion. With my eyes wide open, I'm dreaming. Do I deserve such a brave? Pinch me to prove I'm aware. I can't believe that you're really mine.
Thank you, Germ. I'm glad you liked it.
I'm glad you're glad I like it, because if you weren't glad that I was glad, well, we just wouldn't have a basis.
I'd like to put in my vote, too, Dean, although it's kind of hard for me to appreciate a male singer without a guitar in his hand.
Dale, I think we're going to have to close up shop, and thanks a lot for coming over.
Yeah, and thanks for being such a real swell sport, Dale. Please tell Roy and Trigger it was all in fun, huh?
I know Roy won't mind, but Trigger may not speak to you for months. Good night, fellas.
Good night,
folks. Thank you.
Well, until next week, this is Dean Martin.
And Jerry Lewis reminding you that we appear on radio through the courtesy of Hal Wallace Productions, producers of our soon-to-be-released picture, Sailor Beware.
Good night, folks.
Good night, everybody, and Happy New Year.
Hollywood, you have just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Written by Ed Simmons and Norman Lear. Produced and directed by Dick Back, with music under the direction of Dick Stabile. Brought to you by Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield's mildness, plus no unpleasant aftertaste. By Anacin, for fast relief from pain of headaches, neuritis, and neuralgia. By Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor. And by Beam and Pep, gum that's great to chew and good for your digestion, too.